Good morning and shalom everyone. It's great to have you join us for another Family Sunday. Today, we are delighted to have two lovely couples with us to share on the topic of praying through a crisis as family. We'll be hearing from the Roleys, Jess and Simon, followed by the Tans, Raymond and Sherry, whom are my dear parents. But first, let us come together to joyfully give thanks to our Lord and praise His name.
Thinking of me, that you love me, it's amazing. I'm a friend of God, I'm a friend of God, I'm a friend of God, He calls me friend. Who am I? Amazing. I'm a friend of God.
He calls me friend. I'm a friend of God.
I'm a friend of God. I'm a friend of God. I'm a friend of God. He calls me friend. God Almighty, Lord of glory, you have called me friend. God Almighty, Lord of glory, you have called me friend. God Almighty, Lord of glory, you have called me friend.
God Almighty,
God Almighty, Lord of glory, you have called me friend.
I'm a friend of God. I'm a friend of God. I'm a friend of God, He calls me friend. I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God, He calls me friend. I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God. I am a friend of God, He calls me friend.
Back to the heart of worship.
God, in our worship this morning, we are assured of your gift of life to us and the privileges of being your children. Hold us in your embrace of fatherly love and forgiveness. Enable us to sense your love, your embrace, and your forgiveness to us, O God. Wrap us in the stillness of your peace, and to know that you are always with us. On this Family Sunday, we thank you for holding us as one family in Christ Jesus through these trying and difficult times. O God, keep us closer to you, that we may be closer to one another by your perfect love and watchful care over us. We pray for our families, that we will grow together in awareness of your love, that our lives together may reflect your goodness and salvation. We thank you for your healing upon the infirmed and unwell, by bringing relief and good health to them. Your healing, O God, is not just physical healing, but the healing of shalom. The healing that is holistic, which covers all aspects of our lives and living. And for those who are in need of continuing healing and are undergoing treatment, dear God, uphold them by your healing grace and mercy. Restore them to good health. We pray for our beloved nation, comprising multi-races, cultures, and languages. May we be a nation of justice and reconciliation, of peace and unity, of compassion, caring, and sharing. O God, stretch forth your hand to heal and to restore us, and draw us to yourself and to one another. We pray, O God, for transparent, just, and commendable governance in the context of Keluarga Malaysia under our new Prime Minister. As a church, make us fervent in reaching out to the community by our ministries of education and assistance to the needy. Let all our ministry touch people by the love of Jesus Christ. All this we pray in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus. Amen.
Good morning, church. I am Jess Lolly, and I'm here today with my wife, Saran Lolly. We came to Ipoh in the year 2001. I was introduced to this church in 2006 by a friend who had moved back from Sabah. He had attended the ACS school in Ipoh and was a member of this church. This friend has since passed away. After attending the church for a few years, in 2017, we decided to become members. We also spent a part of our lives in the US, where we attend the Methodist Church of Reno, Nevada. Our daughter Linda, who is a medical doctor, lives in Birmingham, Alabama, in the southern part of the US. After graduating from the University of California in 1971, I started working in the silicon industry in California. At this time, I felt the need for spiritual guidance in my life, and after reading the Bible, I decided to follow the Christian teachings. In 1972, Saran and I started attending the Baptist Church of Los Altos Hills, where we lived at that time. And in 1977, we were baptized at that church. On August 1st, 2021, we celebrated 50 years of marriage. The years together have been filled with blessings and challenges, good health and poor health. Each time we brought our feelings and thoughts to the Lord and prayed for His blessings and love. First, when our daughter Linda was born in 1975, God's gift from heaven. Then, through the many years of building our lives, putting Linda through school and college, moving up the corporate ladder, working hard for success and achievements, wanting a better life and future. All this was possible since the Lord stood with us. In 2010, we were in an auto accident. Though severely injured, I came out of this. Then in 2015, I went through a triple bypass surgery. Each time I submitted to the Lord and placed my life and health in His hands. He was always there for me. In Philippians chapter 4, verses 6 and 7, I read that the Lord said, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus." With the COVID-19 pandemic, we are very grateful to our Lord that so far we have managed to stay healthy. In July 2020, I came back to Malaysia from Reno. Saran was supposed to come back in September. However, due to many circumstances related to COVID-19, she was unable to come back to Malaysia and I was alone till May of 2021. During that time, I depended on the blessings of the Lord to keep me safe and healthy, and also prayed the same for my family. And God protected us all during this separation, which ended up being almost 10 months. I did have a problem with my right eye in April 2020. It got quite bad, as I would lose vision very often and the loss of vision would last from a few to several hours. I was terrified losing my vision and prayed a lot. I was guided to Deuteronomy chapter 31, verse 6, which reads, "Be strong and courageous, do not fear or be in dread of them, for it is the Lord your God who goes with you. He will not leave you or forsake you." These are God's words to His children, and I had faith that He will not forsake me. At this time, dear Judy Chin from our church came to know of my situation and immediately, as if directed by God, came to my assistance. She introduced me to Dr. Lee, and after some testing, Dr. Lee diagnosed me as having a displaced lens as a cause of the problem. To make the long story short, I had surgery on the eye on June 4th, 2021, and now I'm fully recovered with the blessings of the good Lord. I am forever thankful to our church and friends who prayed for my recovery. This testimony will not be complete if I did not share with you today all the reasons why I chose Christianity. First of all, Jesus Christ died for us so that we may live. Secondly, as a Christian, I have faith that I will be in the kingdom of heaven with Lord Jesus upon my death. We do not believe in reincarnation as some religions do. Finally, Christianity is a loving religion. We believe in the good of all people, and more importantly, we believe in forgiveness and giving a second chance in life to all, because we know that we are not perfect. Thank you and have a blessed day.
Good morning, church. I wish all a very happy and blessed Sunday morning. May our Lord bless each one of us as we go through this day and every day of our lives. I am Saran Rolly, and this is my husband, Jess, who just spoke before me. It's Family Sunday today, and the church has requested both Jess and I to share how God has been and is still working in our lives during this pandemic. Before I share this, I want to go back to when I was about 9 years of age. My dad was transferred from Johor Bahru to Kuala Lumpur. There, I was enrolled at St. Mary's Girls' School. This was a Christian school run by the Church of England. A daily prayer service was held in the school hall for all students except for Muslim students who were excused. My introduction to Christianity ended here until, as Jess just spoke, we were introduced to church teachings. Verse 7 in Psalm 36 reads, "How precious is your steadfast love, O God! The children of mankind take refuge in the shadow of your wings." God's steadfast love in this verse helps us understand his benevolence and how he acts kindly towards people who take refuge under his wings. Mid-March 2020 marked the arrival of COVID-19 into all of our lives. Jess, our daughter Linda, and I were in different spaces and locations of the world. We were challenged through COVID-19 and personal health issues. The challenges were many, and we prayed for some light at the end of this very dark tunnel. Fear crippled our hearts. The illness was scary, and we watched as it took many lives, and still is to this day. It was time for prayer and hope that this too shall pass. How did we know that God's light was with us? At many a time we did not know this. We prayed and sought for his guidance, while at the same time giving thanks that our family and friends were blessed and he was caring for all of us. The days passed into weeks, and soon it was time to plan our return from Reno to Ipoh. Jess was able to get his permits and returned in July 2020. I was to fly back in September 2020, and the airline kept canceling my flight. The Malaysian borders were closed. Airlines were not flying to most countries. It was a stressful time. The holidays came and went. This was a lonely time for reflecting, searching and reaching out to God, and for placing my faith and trust in his hands. I went to church service every Sunday. For me, this was a time of prayer where I could be with friends in the house of the Lord. During this time, wildfires raged in Reno. One was less than a mile from our home. The winds were high and the fire showed no mercy, razing homes and hundreds of acres of land. I had no idea of the danger that was so close to me until I saw flames billowing in the sky from my living room window. No Jess at home, not many people I knew. My only companions were two very uncontrollable enemies, COVID-19 and this crazy wildfire. It was God's steadfast love that came knocking on the doors of my heart. I think he spoke and reassured me that all would be well. When God gives, he gives with abundance, and this is not always appreciated. This time, we received in abundance his love and a shower of scary challenges. This made me think of the challenges that God instructed Moses to throw into the laps of the Egyptians. April 2021 marked a new chapter in our lives. Jess called me one morning and he said he was losing vision in his right eye. He said, "I'm blind in this eye." I am not sure that I prayed, but quickly I reached out to a dear friend. I needed to find a reliable person who was kind, loving, and understanding. This angel immediately took over and made arrangements for Jess to see Dr. Lee, one of the best surgeons in Ipoh. Today, Jess's vision is back. The Lord heard our cry for his presence. He is the surgeon in our lives. He guided the hands of Dr. Lee, hearts of our friends at Ipoh Wesley, my friends in Reno. We all prayed hard for Jess, asking God for his mercies. And the Lord listened. I received my travel papers from the Malaysian Immigration Department on compassionate grounds to travel back to Malaysia. Spent 2 weeks in quarantine and arrived in Ipoh just 1 week before Jess's surgery so I could be with him. I still received messages from our friends at Ipoh Wesley and our friends in Reno that they are continuing to pray for Jess. My heart is touched and my eyes are filled with tears. Before I left Malaysia, Pastor Jason from our church in Reno guided me to Psalm 23, verse 4, which reads, "Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me." The Lord was indeed my shepherd. His rod and his staff comforted me. He answered my prayers and gave me guidance and strength to be at peace with him and with myself. From all this, I learned that God is our Savior and he is with us always. During this time, Jess and I were continents apart. Our friends in Ipoh and Reno ministered to us. They gave us strength and prayed with us. This is how good and loving our God is to all his children. Wherever we are, God is always with us, in us, and knows our needs always. Pray and reach out. He reaches back. He sends his children to your side. They are his angels, friends, doctors, pastors, children, even immigration authorities. There is kindness in everyone. This is God's abundant love and grace that is being manifested through people. So please, during this difficult COVID-19 pandemic, keep your faith. God is your Father. He is our Father, a kind parent, and he will always be our strength. Parents never forsake their children. So now as I close this message, I would like to share a song with you. It goes, "Father, I place into your hands the things I cannot do." Please feel free to sing along. May God bless us all. Thank you for listening.
Father, I place into your hands the things I cannot do. Father, I place into your hands the things that I've been through. Father, I place into your hands the way that I should go. For I know I always can trust you.
Father, I place into your hands my friends and family. Father, I place into your hands the things that trouble me. Father, I place into your hands the person I would be. For I know I always can trust you.
Father, we love see your face, we love to hear your voice. Father, we love to sing your praise and in your name rejoice. Father, we love to walk with you and in your presence rest. For we know we always can trust you. Father, I want to be with you and do the things you do.
Father, I want to speak the words that you are speaking to.
Father, I want to love the ones that you will draw to you. For I know that I am one with you. For I know that I am one with you. Thank you.
Shalom, Pastor, and brother and sister in Christ. I'm Sherry, and I would like to give thanks and praises to our mighty and awesome God for His grace and mercy. He is faithful and just, and I praise Him for the assurance of His steadfast love that's written in Lamentations chapter 3, verses 22 and 23. It reads, "Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for His compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness." He is my Creator, my Savior, and my Protector. The Lord is my healer, the greatest physician. I thank the Lord for sending His helper, my precious Holy Spirit. He is my comforter. Thank you, Lord. I'm forever grateful. In Matthew 17, verse 20, it says we can move every mountain if we can pray in faith. I believe that prayer moves mountains. I take this opportunity to thank all of God's mighty prayer warriors that has been praying for me fervently and unceasingly. I'm so grateful and thankful, and I praise God for equipping His intercessors. For the prayer of a righteous man is powerful and effective. Hallelujah. The Lord has saved me from death and near death several times. I'm so grateful to God, my Lord Jesus Christ, and my precious Holy Spirit. In March 2009, I've had a pituitary brain surgery. Praise God, it's benign. I've almost lost my sight then, as the tumor was also compressed into my optic nerve. I thank God for restoring my health and eyesight after my surgery. Glory to God. Before I was diagnosed of having brain tumor for about 3 months, I have pains and aches all on my joints, my hands, my legs, and my body. I saw GPs who were our panel of doctors in the clinic. They kept changing the medicines prescribed for me several times because those medicines did not work, as they could not lessen my aches and pains. Later on, I noticed that my eyesight had deteriorated very quickly. I went to an optical shop and had them checked. The optician suggested that I make a pair of glasses. Few days later, on my way to collect my glasses, which was less than 1 kilometer away from my house, I was driving slowly and I noticed that there were all smaller cars with lesser digits in their registration plates on the road that day. What a coincidence, I thought. But as I drove further, I sensed something wasn't right with my eyes. I also started to see double vision. I had difficulty focusing in my driving. I prayed for God to allow me to arrive at the shop safely in the hope of after getting my new glasses, everything would be well again. Halfway through, suddenly I heard a voice telling me to stop my car. I thought it was my imagination and drove on slowly. Again, it said quietly, "Stop." But I was already driving very carefully and slowly, but I slowed down. Then the Holy Spirit said, "Stop now." I pressed hard on my brakes. Only then I saw the light blue bus kilang that had stalled right in front of my car, just a feet or less than 2 feet away. Praise God! And thank you, Holy Spirit, for saving me. I managed to arrive at the optical shop, but to my dismay, as I tried on the glasses, it couldn't help adjust my eyesight at all. The optician just told me to consume more of the Chinese herbs like the wolfberries, etc., to strengthen my eyes. He claimed my eyes were just weak. Gripped with fear now, I prayed for the guidance of Holy Spirit to lead me in my drive home safely. In my mind, I thought I might be having glaucoma. The next day, my husband and I went to see an ophthalmologist. By then, my eyes worsened as I couldn't see clearly. My vision was grayish and blurred. When I looked straight ahead, I'm only able to see 2 fingers on my hand, when I stretch my arm out. I couldn't see both my side views anymore. They were all in gray. I failed in all eye tests. When the MRI report was out later, the ophthalmologist instructed us to see a neurosurgeon immediately, as there was a growth and bleeding in my brain as well. He said I was lucky to have discovered it just in time, as optic nerve when damaged cannot be repaired since it's not irreversible, he informed us. I knew I wasn't lucky. It was my mighty God that has preserved and protected me all along. Glory to his name. When we rushed to the neurosurgeon in KPJ, Dr. Fazlicia was waiting for us. I remembered clearly him saying, as I saw you standing there, by right you ought to be in a wheelchair, paralyzed, or could have died. God is so good. He is mighty. Praise his name. I went ahead with the brain surgery, and by God's grace, my eyesight was restored, and my aches and pains were immediately relieved. Thank you, dear Lord Jesus. I was covered with prayers of God's intercessors and was so blessed with God's assurance in Romans chapter 8, verse 31. It says, if God is for us, who can be against us? 12 years had passed by. I'm so grateful to God. The last 3 years had been a busy time for us. My daughter Olive left for UK and Jasmine also left for her college in KL. We decided to downsize and move to our new condo in Upper East. I was busy looking for IDs, overseeing contractors in renovation works, as well as packing and unpacking loads of stuffs. Then we left for Olive's graduation in UK, just 3 days after moving in quickly into our new home. We were away in UK for a month, and 2 days after arrival back in Ipoh, we were shocked to discover that our house in Meru Heights were burglarized while we were away. Cupboards were pushed down, rooms and cabinets and all drawers were pulled out, ransacked, and things were thrown all over the place. The whole house was in such a mess, needless to say. I thank my wonderful and faithful God that no one was in when the burglary happened. God is our protector. He is in control. Prior to our leaving the country, all important documents and most of our valuable things have been moved to our condo. God is good. My recent headaches started in March this year. My MRI of the brain detected a recurrence of tumor of about 3.1 cm with microhemorrhage in the left brain. There were other complications initially too that baffled both my neuro and radiologist. My very caring and supportive small group, the BSF ladies group, and also the mighty warriors of our own church here in Wesley, as well as my other Christian sister and brothers elsewhere, started praying for me unceasingly. Praise the Lord for sending in his army. We started to pray for wisdom in both neuro and radiologists to give the right diagnosis and scan to be interpreted correctly, and in making and giving good decisions too. We pray for growth to stop growing and to shrink, and we pray for the microhemorrhage in the left brain to stop. We pray against a dissection of the left vertebral artery. Glory be to God. When neuro told me after my CT angiogram of the brain reported there's no dissection detected, but it could be just a dilation and not to worry about it. Hallelujah. Praise God. We prayed again for the right oncologist, neurologist, and team of medical officers to operate the cyber knife machine effectively and efficiently with such precision to destroy tumor cells and to stop tumor growth while avoiding damage to other healthy tissues. We continued to pray for God to give doctors the gift of word of knowledge, precise handling of the equipments, to do exactly what he needs to do, nothing more and nothing less. I know in my heart that God is in control. Amen. I had 3 sessions of cyber knife radiosurgery in Mount Miriam, Penang, on 18, 20th and 22nd of May. Each lasted 40 minutes on alternate days. Praise the Lord, all three sessions went well. I'm only to return to Mount Miriam after 6 months, that's in November, to check on the growth of the tumor. In the meantime, I need to see an endocrinologist. My first appointment with the endocrinologist was last Wednesday on the 18th of May. I was reprimanded by her when she read through my cortisol results in May. It was only 3.4. She said it would have dropped even further now. The normal reading should be within 6 to 28. She said it was so low that I could have collapsed and died any moment. I was immediately prescribed with hydrocortisone. I'm so thankful and grateful to God for protecting me from all harms again and again. Our God is able, He is mighty, and He is forever faithful. May His name be exalted forevermore. I'm so thankful and blessed for Psalms 1:1. It reads, I lift up my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade or at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore. Amen. Dawn Moon sang this song titled, He Never Sleeps. It says, He never sleeps, He never slumber. He never tires of hearing our prayer. When we are weak, He becomes stronger. So rest in His love and cast all of your cares on Him. All honor, glory, and power be unto our Lord. Thank you. And thank you for your prayers.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. As you have heard my wife's testimony of the crisis we went through, we have gone through 4 major crises in the last 20 years. We thank God for His protection, that we overcome it to praying together as a family, trusting the Lord for His peace in making decisions to go for this major high-risk surgery. How do we as a family always be willing to come together as one to trust and pray to God in faith? Well, as a father, I believe that it is my responsibility to train up our children in the way of the Lord, that when he is old, he will not depart from it. Proverbs 22 verse 6. So I started to lay my hands and pray for my 2 princesses when they are still in the womb of their mother. As they grew up, I trained them up in prayer and reading the Bible. We always do our family altar daily, and we as parents teach the girls to pray when they started to learn to speak. Whenever we face any crisis in our life, whether it's minor or major, I always remind myself with this verse. Be ye anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and supplications, let our requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which passes all human understanding, shall keep your hearts and mind to Christ Jesus. Philippians 4 verse 6 to 7. And this is also Jasmine's favorite verse. The first crisis happened in 2002 when I was diagnosed with sleep disc. I collapsed in the toilet and was sent to hospital and was hospitalized for 2 weeks at KBJ. After about 2 years, in 2004, there was a relapse while I was doing physiotherapy treatment in the hospital. I was bedridden in Bantai Hospital for 2 weeks. I was in excruciating pain whenever I moved my body. I couldn't go to the toilet. I had to do everything in bed. I lost 6 to 8 kgs, and it was a very painful and depressing experience. I was diagnosed with multiple syphilis. Two discs were displaced, L3, L4, and L5 and L6. I asked the orthopedic doctor, was this common? He was honest and told me that this was the second case that he came across a patient with multiple syphilis. Since this was a rare case of multiple syphilis and not many surgeries were done by him, I went and seek consultations from 4 back specialists, 3 GPs, to get their knowledge, understanding of the advantages and disadvantages of going for this high-risk surgery. With the peace of God in my heart, I decided to go ahead with the surgery and cover prayers for my family and the church members. I was led to an experienced orthopedic doctor who have done many such cases. So I had to transfer to Hospital Fatima by an ambulance. I remember Olive, who was 6 years old, showed her love and courage to accompany her father in the ambulance to the hospital. Well, praise the Lord, the surgery was successful and I was able to celebrate that year, Chinese New Year, back home. Praise God, He is Jehovah Rapha, my healer. I remember a significant moment in the hospital chapel. As I was praying, there was a flashback in my mind, reminding me of the time I spent in prayer as a student in the St. Michael Church Chapel. In the hospital chapel at that moment, I heard a still small voice speaking, "I am with you always." Tears just flow down and I sense of comfort and assurance of God's love for me. I felt the wonderful presence of God and I knew the Lord was with me all this while. Well, as we move forward, another crisis happened in 2009. My wife told me she couldn't see well and had a near miss on the way home that day. So we decided to see the eye specialist the next day. And this time, the doctor diagnosed there was a growth in the brain between the second and the sixth optic nerves. He told us there were 2 possibilities. Either she would go blind or she had a tumor in her brain which needed to be removed. On that night, I went down on my knees to pray after my family altar and putting the girls to sleep. I was confused and fear just gripped into me as thoughts of what would happen if my wife was blind or having that big C. Should I resign to take care of the children? Olive was just 11 years old and Jasmine was 7 years old. Do I have enough money to sustain our lives? Then I felt the Lord just rebuilt me and reminded me to stop thinking of these negative thoughts, but trust in Him and commit my wife's life to Him. He brought this song to my remembrance. Trust and obey. There's no other way but to be happy in Jesus, but to trust and obey. This song reminded me of Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and 6 says, Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your paths. Well, the next day, we went to see the neurosurgeon, and he told us that the tumor was benign and is non-cancerous. Praise the Lord. However, she had to go for the surgery to remove this tumor, which was about 4 cm to 3 cm. In this aspect, I've learned to trust God and agree to let her go for the surgery. Well, praise God. God healed her. He is Jehovah Rapha, our healer. In 2012, a third crisis came into our life again. I had a burning pain in the shoulder blades, and it radiates down my arms and it affected my sleep. There was also numbness and tingling sensations at my second and third fingers in both hands. My neck problem became very serious, and I was diagnosed with multiple sleep disc again at C4, C5, and C5 and C6. And this happened while I attended a 2-week ministry degree course at Tung Ling Seminary in Subang Jaya. I had to wear a neck support in the classes for the second week. It was a challenge of my faith and commitment to the Lord. Should I consider surgery or continue to go on treatment with physiotherapy? Well, God is so good. He brought to my knowledge of 6 people who had successful neck surgeries to assure me that it was safe to go for the operation. 3 of the patients had their successful operations carried out by the same orthopedic specialist whom I've entrusted him to do it. Once again, with the peace of God in my heart and prayer support for my family, brothers and sisters in Christ all over the country, I went for the operation. Well, God is good again. The surgery was successful. I can still bend my neck and see my pair of feet, and I had a titanium neck. Well, lastly, the 4th crisis in our family was just recently happened, as been shared by my wife, of a tumor reoccurrence. Once again, we committed it to the Lord in prayer as a family. I have to decide the type of radio surgery between gamma knife, which cost $30,000, and cyber knife, which cost $50,000. I learned to trust the Lord for His provision, even though my wife does not have insurance coverage, as we decided to go for the cyber knife surgery at Mount Miriam Hospital, Penang. This is the most advanced form of surgery that is painless, non-invasive treatment that shoots high doses of precisely targeted radiation to destroy the tumors. So I decided that I will sacrifice Jasmine, education and endowment of $50,000, which mature in May this year. Simultaneously, without my knowledge, my wife decided to sell her gold and jewelry, which came to about $35,000 to cover part of the surgery cost. The following day, I received an SMS message from a couple whom the Holy Spirit prompted them in their family altar to contribute $15,000 towards the cost of the treatment. When I saw that message, I felt I couldn't accept this contribution because they are more worthy and needy people than us. So I decided to share this matter with my family and committed to the Lord in prayer. My wife too struggled to accept this gift, since we do have enough to cover the treatment cost. However, my eldest daughter, Olive, reminded us that Pastor Tan Moy Hau say that if you are being blessed financially by others, you should be humble to accept it as God's blessing to the giver. Furthermore, she reminded us that we have been giving to others too. Why do we find so difficult to receive and accept other well wishes too? This is God's blessing to us, she said. As I pray again over this matter, the Holy Spirit reminded me with this statement. Why do you stop my channel of blessing to others? For it is written, it is more blessed to give than to receive, in Acts chapter 20, verse 35. And by the grace of God, we are very grateful and thankful to accept the generosity and blessings from the Lord, from this couple. Once again, our Lord, Jehovah Jireh, He is our provider. Well, the cyberknife surgery was successful, and today my spouse can come forward to give her testimony just now, to give glory to God. Lastly, I greatly want to thank the Lord that in all this crisis, we felt the presence of God in our family. We come together as a family to pray daily for His protection, not only in crisis moment only. It's the peace of God which passes all human understanding shall keep our mind and our heart in Christ Jesus, which guide us in making the right decision. Our Lord is Jehovah Jireh, who is a great provider. The cause of the previous three surgeries were borne by my ex-company. Truly, our God is a great God, whom we can trust Him and communicate with Him daily. May God bless you. Shalom.
Wow, Alvin, this testimony is just so good and a living proof of the goodness of our God. Indeed, He's our Jehovah Rapha and Jehovah Jireh. Our God is enough. Our God is a faithful God, and He will strengthen and protect us from evil, as per 2 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 3. Like in the song Egypt by Corey Asbury and Better Music, which is based on Exodus chapter 14, one of the lyrics says, "Our God, He stepped into my Egypt. He took me by the hand. He marched me out in freedom, straight into the promised land." Indeed, Exodus chapter 14, verse 14 says, "The Lord will fight for you. You only need to be still." I have been greatly encouraged by our brothers and sisters in Christ's testimony, and I hope you are too. Now, it is time for offering prayer. Father in heaven, we thank you today for your blessings that you have bestowed upon us all. You said, "Give, and it will be given to you. For in the same measure as you give, it will be given to you again." We ask that you accept our tithes and offering as a gift of worship to you. Lord, will you multiply what we give for the furthering of your work in your kingdom? All this we ask and pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Stories of what they think you're like. I've heard Heavenly Father, it's who you are, it's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. Searching for answers far and wide, but I know we're all searching for answers. Only you provide, 'cause you are just what we need before we say a word. Our good, good Father, it's who you are, it's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. To us, you are perfect in all of your ways.
Let us pray. In peace, we will lie down and sleep. In the Lord alone, we safely rest. Guide us that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in Him. May the divine help remain with us always. May the God of hope fill you all with joy and peace, so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.